Now, usually I don't do this, but go ahead on, break them off with a little previews of the remix. Now, I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do reminds me of my Lexus cool. That's why I'm all up in your grill, trying to get you to a hotel. You must be a football coach, the way you got me playing the field. So, baby, give me that and let me get that. Running her hands through my fro, bouncing on 24s. Why they saying I'm ready?
It's the remix to Ignition.
What's up, everybody? Big Will, K-pop for life, coming back at you. And in today's episode of K-pop Rants, we're going to be talking about the group Priston and all the drama and BS surrounding them at the moment, when there should be none. This should be an extremely successful, hyped up group that has blown up in the K-pop market. But as usual, Pletus Entertainment and their inability to properly manage their groups has repeated history. And we're having a newest after-school situation type thing again, where the group is just going to implode. And I can't tell you why. I don't really know the details, but let's look at some of the information we do have. And this all stems from a recent report that Ziyun, or however the hell you say her name, has decided that she wanted to leave Priston. And a report came out saying, hey, I'm going to be leaving the group, this and that, blah, blah, blah. Immediately afterwards, Pletus Entertainment came out and
said, no. Everything's fine. She's not leaving the group. Please don't sell our stock. We're everything's good.
And usually these kind of things tend to have at least a grain of truth in them. And eventually the truth does come out, i.e. let's just look at Cube Entertainment with Hyuna and Edan. We all know how that shit turned out. So, and a countless other examples too. So in this situation, Pletus states that she's still training with the group. Everything's fine, blah, blah, blah. I get that. That's a business speak. But if you read between the lines and you look at what's actually going on, you've got a 10-member group that within a half a year of its debut, due to insane amounts of asshole, vitriolic dumbasses going after a 15-year-old girl in Kayla that were calling her fat and all this and that and stuff that she was not ready for or prepared properly for, that caused her to actually basically have what tantamounts to a mental break and go back to the States. And I think now she's working at like a carnival or something, just trying to have a normal life. And people are giving shit for that too. It's like, oh, she's blah, 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 she's only working at a carnival. Listen, just a quick side tangent. She's probably working at a carnival making what? $8 an hour, right? She's probably making more than half of the girl group members make out there by themselves right now. It's just not glamorous because most of these girl groups, they aren't even getting paid yet. WJSN hasn't got a fucking single paycheck, and they've debuted like 4 years ago. So keep your bullshit high and mighty bullcrap to yourself, okay? She's got a job, she's working, and she's trying to have a normal life. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Back on track. I understand why the rest of these members may be getting very antsy at the moment because they just had a comeback, but it was just a subgroup with only 5 members. What about the other remaining 4? They are a group that had 7. Please try to think back. And if you're new to K-pop, you won't understand this. But think about this. Produce 101 came out like 3-4 years ago, right? Produce 101 was a fucking massive success. It blew up, right? It has inspired multiple copycats across the country. Across the region in China and other places. It is a formula that works. 7 of the members of Pletus's 10 were contestants on Produce 101, and many of them went really deep into that contest. So Pletus Entertainment really dropped the fucking ball, and they didn't just drop the ball. They dropped it like a Looney Tunes cartoon through like 20 floors, and then it smashed into somebody's head and left one of them big-ass things. Pletus fucked up. 7 of your 10 members are from a show that already gave your rookie group huge amounts of notoriety and huge amount of name recognition before they even came out. And to take it one step further, 2 of the members in Naeyoung and Pinky, I'm not even going to try to pronounce her real name, in Naeyoung and Pinky were actual members of IOI.
You fucked up, Cletus.
What are you doing? I'm just going to start calling you Cletus Entertainment because y'all some dumbass yokels at this point. And it makes no sense why they wouldn't fucking just crank out comebacks. I do not understand it. There has got to be some kind of underlying issue within that organization that is stopping them. I don't know if it's money related. I don't know if it's some kind of weird, like, we don't really want a girl group, but we had to capitalize on this. Because when they came out, they were so hyped. They weren't even my personal favorite of all the groups that formed or had a member from IOI join them. But I really liked Preston. And you could see that Cletus had a broad appeal. And all they needed was that one fucking song. You know what I'm saying? Is it that hard to want to make money with a product that you already have built? And that is, you don't even have to, like, promote the shit. You can just put it out there and, like, here's a cool song. Go be attractive and sing it good. That's all you had to do. They had two songs that were really good, and they were pretty big hits. And then nothing. They haven't come back in, like, almost a year. It's such bullshit. I don't understand it. I don't understand. There's so many record labels that do this. They have this, like, golden egg in their fucking lap, and they just shit on it. I don't understand. So Cletus Entertainment has completely basically ruined this group. I'm sensing that if there is a comeback, at this point, you've waited too long. You have what is essentially a rookie group now. Like the craze and the crazy fans and the super love for the members that came from IOI and everything, it's sort of died off a little bit because you've had such an injection of new K-pop fans into K-pop that they're just going to see this as a new group. You missed your window. You missed your window. And I feel really bad for Preston because Preston deserved better than that. Preston could have been like Momoland big, right? They could have blown up. They could have had a ton of success. And it's such a waste. And it's like a classic story. It's one of those classic, don't fucking do this stupid shit stories that you see way too often in K-pop. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. If you guys like what you see and you want to see more, don't click the subscribe button. Go watch a few more of my videos. Make sure you like, you know, what I'm putting into this relationship between me and you. And if you want to be with me for the long haul, because I am not some whore on a one-night stand. I'm in this for marriage, right? I want to have kids with you, and I want us to build a life together. So once you decide that that's something you want, you hit that subscribe button. Hit the bell button, all right? Because those are like our babies in like a weird way. And as always, keep on popping, K-poppers. Remember, it's not a trend. It's a lifestyle. Deuces.